Rachel had the idea of trying to make some maple syrup, so Rachel and Harriet have been tapping the five maple trees near the house and starting to collect the sap. And then I got into it too.
We've been experimenting with making maple syrup by boiling it in a rice cooker, but I had the idea of using this kettle, but I want to shut off the kettle before it gets too empty. So I made this balance here so that when the liquid in the kettle gets too low, it'll get lighter. So if I take a little bit of weight off of here, that makes a tip, and that disengages this switch, which will cut the power to the kettle. Now the thing is, overnight electricity here is cheaper than actually using propane for this sort of thing. So what I'd like to do is run this overnight, but that means I need an automatic way of refilling the kettle. I've done a whole lot more tinkering off camera, and here's how I think this is going to work. When the kettle comes up, it's going to lift this wire, which has this crank here, and that's going to pull the crank away from the bucket. So I'm going to drill a hole in the bucket right here, and this will have some kind of rubber stopper on it. I couldn't find anything to use as a stopper, so I have this piece of rubber here that hinges on the copper wire. And so hopefully, if I get that lined up properly with the hole, that will plug it up until I raise the wire. Well, that's leaking a bit fast, but if I apply just a tiny bit of weight on here, it's manageable. And if I lift it up, it runs good. Well, this is all starting to look very Rube Goldberg. I added this spout to direct the sap into the kettle. Here's the thing that pushes this up to open this valve. Right now, there's nothing in the kettle. So I'm going to give this a dry run by putting some water in a bucket to make sure the kettle drops. Except right now, I've got a light plugged in instead of the kettle. Well, I'm losing a lot of sap that is not going into the kettle. It's running along this. It slowed down quite a bit. Oh, overshoot. And now most of the water is running off the side. The surface tension is just guiding it way to the side. This is very frustrating. All right, I tweaked the spout and the bucket. The kettle is currently deemed to be full enough, but I don't really have a lot of weight on here, so I put a weight on here that turns off the kettle, turns on the water. And so this will slowly fill. Nope, except now it's missing the kettle. And I'm losing slightly less water, but normally this will not be flowing as fast because it'll only just barely keep the kettle filled as it goes. And now it's turned on the kettle. So we've got enough water for that. And as it sinks, it should turn off most of the water. That's good. Excellent. This Rube Goldberg thing seems to actually be working. Now, as the water slowly boils away, the kettle will get lighter. I'm not actually boiling it right now. That would take far too long, but I'm just going to slowly add counterweight to pretend that the kettle has gotten lighter. So it should start turning on the water when I do that. And there it goes. It should turn on the water well before it turns off the kettle because I basically just want to maintain the level in the kettle until we're completely out of water in the bucket, at which point we turn off the kettle. I plugged in the kettle and brought it to a full boil because I wanted to see where the steam was going to go. I'm afraid that steam might mess up some of the wooden parts of this machine. And it's rocking back and forth a little bit just from the agitation from the steam. And I think this thing is slowly coming up to request more water. And it's almost touching now. So the kettle has gotten lighter. There, I think it's touching now. It should raise this just enough for replacement rate in the kettle. And now it's a minute later, and this is the rate at which it's dripping into the kettle, which is probably about as fast as it's making steam. Now, releasing all the steam in my workshop, not a great idea. So I have to shut this down and then try it outside with some real sap. I put some tinfoil around the kettle to cut down on heat loss so that more of the heat goes into boiling, and I also ran into a problem. The sap actually foams up much more than water does. So I've bent open the spout quite a bit, and that helps a bit, and I also adjusted the weights so that the level in here would be lower. But that means I'll have less residual in here, which means I shouldn't run a whole bucket full. That bucket is about half full right now. I bent open the top of this kettle a little bit just to deal better with the foaming, but then I could see inside and there's lots of solder in there, and given the age of this kettle, I can be pretty sure this is lead solder. So I switched back to using the rice cooker and put that on my apparatus. And it's a crispy morning, and this has been boiling all night, and it just ran out and shut off the cooker. And inside we have some more concentrated sap. This is not finished sap yet. It still needs to be reduced by quite a lot.
And I used an electric wok to boil that down to final concentration.
A problem with this rice cooker is that it only draws 500 watts, which makes for a very slow boil. Whereas my lead soldered kettle draws 1800 watts. That was a fast boil. This is so slow a boil that overnight I can't boil away a day's sap run. But I've been doing the finishing boil on this thrift store electric wok, which I've already modified quite a bit. It used to be larger, but if you fill it all the way up, there's just too much heat loss and it doesn't even come to a boil. So I cut it down a bit, and then I bent the edges over like this, and I also modified the lid to get rid of the lip that was here, because normally a pot lid is designed that any condensation on the lid goes in the pot because you don't want to make a mess on the stove. But in my case, actually, I want the condensation from the lid to go outside the pot, because if it goes in the pot, it just needs to be boiled again, and that's a waste of energy. I also made the top of it more dome-shaped, again, to help guide the water down the sides, and I made a much bigger hole for my continuous filling contraption. And here we are, set up for another night of boiling. Tinfoil around the wok to cut down on heat loss. This is about the rate at which it's boiling away the water. The sap level is about here. Should get down to the bottom by the morning. It drops by about 2 centimeters every hour. And now a garbage bag around the sap bucket, so hopefully that won't freeze. Alright, it's now 7 a.m., which is when the price of electricity doubles. Let's see what's left in the bucket. Almost done, but I'm going to stop this boil now. Oh, this looks like it's actually at final concentration. I guess it was a bit thicker than I thought it was. I was thinking this needs a finishing boil.
Yummy maple syrup.